Travis Wayne Goodsell, video number 3 that you won't be able to hear, but I'm able to speak loud because nobody's in here yet, I think. Another comment that I had yesterday was on my criticism of the church being caught with their investment scandal, the tithing. And the guy was, Mormon was trying to claim that, who cares? The investments benefit the Mormons. It benefits the whole church. Oh my God, you're so naive. How are you benefiting? Huh? How? How is the church rewarding you? Oh, I get blessings from the temple attendance that you have to pay for. I'm gonna be given a mansion in the celestial kingdom. Yeah. You're not getting a damn thing from the church. Oh my God. I can't believe how Mormons have become such suckers and losers, as they literally believe they're being rewarded by the church as they're having to pay the church, which is called atoning to the church for their wickedness. And they get nothing in return. Now, well, I've gone over this with you guys. This is just a repeat in a different format for you. 1923. The United States had long shut down the church. 1887. Edmunds Tucker Act. Church closed. Ceased to exist on the face of the earth. No more priesthood authority. Nothing. Squat. The church is a criminal organization and has been shut down. President Grover Cleveland, I believe it is, finally decided to pardon Mormons only for polygamy, not the tithing crimes, which we now call a protection racket, which is usually held by criminal organizations. They're the ones who do that. The Sopranos, Tony Soprano, was running a protection racket with his sanitation business, if you've ever been aware of that. That's what Brigham Young started after the death of Joseph Smith. He required people to pay in order to get into the temple for ceilings and his added creation of the endowment, putting in the ceremony with the garden, all that. That was Brigham Young. That was not Joseph Smith. The magic underwear, not Joseph Smith. Brigham Young. And people pull anachronisms saying, oh yeah, Joseph Smith, oh Joseph. You're not going to your Joseph Smith papers. You're not paying attention. You're just assuming everything has not changed since Joseph Smith. And so in 1923, Heber J. Grant decides, you know, I'm an illegal president of the church, Woodruff likewise. Oh, it is hilarious. The official declaration number one, he calls himself the president of the church. The church was shut down in 1887. What are you doing claiming to be the president? You ain't nothing. You have no authority to lead nobody. He's a self-proclaimed king of nothing. Where's your crown, King Nothing? And he's talking about how the Lord will never... And I did the videos for you. Signs in the heavens for the likeness of things on the earth. Lunar eclipses, and there were some solar ones involved as well. Just hilarious. And Mormons aren't wanting to know. No, the church is true, Jesus. No, guys. Learning of the Jews. Amen. A man like Moses. A Mormon man like Moses. And so you've most likely, because they get hundreds of thousands of views. Other critics, they interview people who are involved with researchers. There's 1921, Heber J. Grant does a revision of the triple combination, takes out the lectures on faith, which is the doctrine of the Doctrine and Covenants. Still calls it the Doctrine and Covenants. And so has the scriptures. The next year, 1922, the woman from Arizona who did her thesis on the secret meeting of intellectuals in the church who are scared, oh no, the church isn't true. What do we do? The Heber J. Grant already knew what he was plotting. But and so the next year, 1923, a reincorporation of the church starts brand new, founded by Heber J. Grant, takes the name of Brigham Young's church. Joseph Smith didn't name it that, Brigham Young did. Pay attention, study your Joseph Smith papers. If you're not going to listen to my videos, which you could hear when I did those, over the Joseph Smith papers. I know it's a lot more scriptures to study, but there's some bombshells. Church ain't true. He says in the Articles of Incorporation, which doesn't get to the members, that they're only to be used for chattel as a source of revenue for the organization. They are not to have a voice in any of the operations. That's all gone. So this, it's all a fraud. They're now only for giving atonement to the church. And only the president of the Quorum of 12 becomes the successor, exactly like the crime boss families. You have the boss, you have counselors for the boss, it's usually just one, and then you have the underboss, president of the 12, and then the lieutenants are the 12, and then soldiers would be the rest of the priesthood. And then associates are those who are not a part of the organization but are on the take. If you understand what that means, they're compromised. And the police officers, the government officers, etc., who are not in the organization. And so he starts up the church brand new, doesn't tell members. They don't want to find out they have no voice anymore. And so, yeah, we do not benefit. They made sure nobody but the leaders benefit. And Harold B. Lee did a reincorporation, adding extra details, saying that when we dissolve the church, yeah, they're going to destroy it. That they have the right to funnel, launder money to offshore accounts, which the Australia case, which has been silenced, man, they got a powerful reach. Disclosed that they do have offshore accounts. And Nelson came out and said, hey, we do the same pattern for every source of income. Take 10% of the donations, tithing is not a donation, and then put it into a financial company, LLC company, in which then gets partially invested in the stock market and gains interest. They don't do anything with it. It's a violation of tax law. The whistleblower explained all this. And so, with the offshore accounts as part of it, yeah, the offshore accounts And so when the church sells their stocks on the stock market and it shows a loss in their financial books, they sold the money. They got money. Where did it go? Offshore accounts. That's what Australia revealed to us. So the church is not hurting as much as they want to distract you. They're purposely plotting and planning for 200 years. They know what they're doing. They know what their end goal is. And I've been trying to warn you, and now you can't hear me. So, oh God. I think that's it. That seems to be the similar thing for the other one. So, yeah, we're all caught up. I'm going to work on today, or at least I got an idea to work on today, whether I actually do or not, I don't know. missing signs from the sign list and how they need to be translated. Not that anybody cares.